Good morning. Glad you could join us. So I want to tell you a story at the beginning about a friend of mine who's a big Cubs fan. Any Cubs fans out there? Yes. And I was totally pulling for the Cubs to win the World Series back in 2016. And a lot of Cubs fans don't believe that I was, but I was. Jesus did this thing in my heart that allowed me to do that. So, but this one friend of mine, we'll call him Joe, because that's his name. And the end of the Cubs World Series victory was much different than the White Sox. The White Sox swept. I'm not saying that's better, but it was better for my nerves because they swept. Now, each game was close, but the Cubs coming back from 3-1 down and then to be ahead the final game and then for the lead to disappear the way it did and then to go into extra innings and the final play of the game, if it gets thrown away, it's tied, or if the guy hit a home run, they would have lost the World Series. But after the whole thing was over, I understand being nervous at the time, but my friend Joe, I don't remember how far long after the World Series was over, he was still nervous. I'm like, Joe, you won. The Cubs won. You can never be taken away. It's like, yeah, but it was so intense. Sometimes we kind of grab a hold of feelings that sometimes we don't have to. So I was watching something. We'll just say there was an award ceremony recently, and I saw someone receiving an award, and I didn't catch the whole thing. Because I wasn't really that into the ceremony. But they were talking about something regarding justice in America and something I think right happened the week before. But they said, but if that didn't happen, they indicated how angry they would have been. Truth be told, I think they still were angry, even though the right thing had happened. So with both those things, I think, well, that's kind of funny. You know, it's like I would never react in any way, shape, or form like that. But then I realized sometimes they do. And sometimes I get anxious over things and I have to kind of do a little self-talk and prayer and say, what are you being anxious about? So I've actually been preaching a lot. Not that you see me anymore here, but this time of year I tend to do a series at another church for their seniors. And but this year, again, just recording it. And so this week I went and recorded twice. So I'm actually doing a lot and I won't see the people. And if you've been listening, you know that that's just kind of my thing. I don't like not seeing people. I like people. And so I've just been a little bit overwhelmed with some things. And so when I sat down the other day to get a message ready for Sunday morning to record on Friday, I was kind of like, I don't really know what I got going here. And I sat down. One of the things I do in the morning to kind of get the brain going is I do a Sudoku. And so I'm doing that. But while I'm doing it, I've got my notepad. Well, this would work well in the message right there. Then I come back to the Sudoku, and then I come back. And in the course of like 10 minutes doing the puzzle, I pretty much had the skeleton frame of the message that I needed. And I kind of put the pen down and I'm like, God, that's pretty cool how you do that, because I really think that that's from you. And I think what God was trying to tell me is, look, even when you're doing a Sudoku puzzle, I'm the one who provides you with the stuff to preach on, or I don't. And I always have. So what are you worried about? If I stop doing it now, you're in trouble, but I never stopped in the past. Is there something you're not trusting God for? Then I'll just say this, that there's a trip I want to do and there's some other things. And I realize I've been buying like worry for tomorrow. I've been buying problems from tomorrow. Jesus said, don't worry about tomorrow. There'll be stuff to worry about, but don't worry about it now. It'll come eventually. And it was really good. I was just able to kind of exhale and say, God, you give me what I need when I need it. The Apostle Paul put it this way. Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Well, there's a novel idea. I've heard some people say, why pray when you can worry? It's like, I think you mean it the other way around. Okay? Tell God what you need. Be specific and thank him for all he's done. Oh, that's a novel idea. Thank him. In advance even. Then you will experience God's peace, which exceeds anything we can understand. His peace will guard your hearts and minds as you live in Christ Jesus. And I know some of you hear this from the book of Philippians, like, yeah. Well, that's St. Paul. He had a halo on. Easy for him to say that. Do you know where he wrote that? In a prison cell. When you've got the peace of God, you've got the peace of God. And when you don't, you don't. And sometimes I don't, but I'm getting it back. God bless you. Have a great day.